Hello, welcome again to the Daily Sporran, and today I'm going to do a song called Roots to Branches from the 1995 Jethro Tull album of the same name. A song which sounds like it's from a different kind of musical tradition to Western rock and pop music because it uses a different modal scale to a lot of Western music. It uses the Phrygian mode, which I'll explain a bit at the end. And it's one of three or four songs on the album that seems to be drawn from Indian or other traditions of music in that sense of using modal scales that are less familiar. Ian Anderson is a fan of the album, and he compared it to Stand Up in terms of the range of palettes and sounds that it uses. I like the lyrics of this song in particular. I think they are a lovely poetic meditation on religion over time, the way in which it changes and doesn't, the relationship between its leaders and its faithful. I'm also a big fan of the team performance of this song on the album. I think that it's a great sort of gelling of Andy Giddings on keyboard, Martin Barr on guitar, and Steve Bailey on bass. Steve Bailey is a professor of music from the US who was brought in to do a few songs on this album. This song in particular, I think, is he has a great performance. Anyway, I hope you enjoy my version. Wish me luck. Twisted, old meanings move in the drift of time. Lift the flickering torches, see gentle shadows change, the features of the faces cut in unmoving stone. Bad mouth on a prayer day, hope no one's listening. To colour just a little with their personal touch. Homespun fancy weavers, the naked half-believers, crusades and creeds descend like fiery flakes of snow. Bad mouth on a prayer day, hope no one's listening. Face on, he better be some quick change artist. suffer little children to make their minds up soon. Bad mouth on a prayer day, hope no one's listening. Roots down in the wet clay, branches glistening. Roots to branches, roots to branches, roots to branches. Thank you. So what's the Phrygian mode? So there are major and minor keys. A major key sounds sunnier and happier. A minor key sounds more moody and melancholic. And the scale, which are the individual notes that comprise the notes in a particular key, this is F sharp minor. The scales consist of those notes, and the natural minor scale is distinguished, it's characterized, I should say, by the spacing of individual notes. Some, think of it in guitar terms, some notes in those scales are 2 frets apart and some are just 1 apart. The natural minor scale begins with, so the bass, the key note, the anchor note, in this case F sharp, second note, which in this case is G sharp, and the third note, which is A. And so the spacing between the first and the second notes in a natural minor scale are 2 spaces on a guitar, 2 semitones. And the spacing between the second and third is 1. Now, in the Phrygian mode, it's distinguished by the fact that the spacing between the first and the second notes is just 1 semitone, 1 fret. So instead of, it's, that may not sound like much, but it makes a big difference. And it's behind a lot of music, like, for example, flamenco music. It uses the chord and the notes based on the first, on a note that's only a semitone above the anchor note, the tonic. And you can hear it in this song. So it gives it that slightly more sort of sideways glancy feel. Those of you who like Pink Floyd might know the song Set the Controls for the Heart of the Sun. That uses the Phrygian mode. So that gives the chorus, which is in F sharp minor. A different musical tradition, as I said at the beginning. Other things I love about this song are the way that in the introduction, which is another Phrygian little, it then skips to the major third of the E rather than the minor third. And in that sense, it reminds me very much of Baker Street Mews. You remember the chorus of Baker Street Mews goes, couldn't take her with the big street blues. That's also that combination of Phrygian and moving from the major to the minor third in F sharp minor, actually exactly the same key. Other little things I love, which are very Tully in this, in the bridge to the chorus. So it goes from D to E, and then A to G, A to G. Bad mouth on a prayer day, hope no one's listening. And then it repeats it. Roots down in the wet clay. But in the wet clay, it reverses the G and the A. So it has a different progression to the E, to the F sharp, sorry. So, first time round, and second time. Lovely. Anyway, hope you enjoyed it. See you soon.